Yeah. Cash money, heroes, private jets, polish.
We have Dr. Cohen on the line here, and we're going to conduct an interview about city and regional planning and Jane Jacobs. Okay, so let's start out with the introduction, and we can begin.
My name is William J. Cohen, Associate Professor of Practice, Department of Community and Regional Planning, School of Environmental Design, Temple University. Education, I have a bachelor's, a BA, and an MA degree from the University of Delaware. I have an MCP, which is a Master of City Planning, a Master of Arts, and a Doctor of Philosophy in City and Regional Planning from the University of Pennsylvania.
Jacobs argued that there are four ingredients to economic success and diversity in the city, which are mixed use, short blocks, variety of buildings, and a high concentration of people. Do you feel that the city has been successful in some of these areas?
Now, you're talking about the city generically, or you're talking about the city of Philadelphia?
City of Philadelphia.
I think so, yeah. And you see, that's a good question, because that really strikes at the heart of the critiques that she was leveling at current city planning.
Mm-hmm.
And as you remember, what really got her fired up was the urban renewal programs. You know, federal urban renewal programs are going to center cities all over the country and basically demolishing whole neighborhoods. And people were being relocated or dislocated. And then they were going to build these new, sterile, high-rise, Corbusier-inspired shoebox-type structures that they call it apartments. And everybody would come back into these apartments, and they live, you know, very comfortable, wonderful, socially connected lives, which turned out to be absolutely false. We have a situation in Philadelphia where you have a very vibrant city. You've got all of the ingredients that you just mentioned in your question. You got mixed neighborhoods. You've got short blocks. You've got long blocks. You've got interconnected neighborhoods, interconnected blocks. You've got residential mixed with commercial and other types of activities.
And are there improvements that can be made in these four areas?
There are always improvements that can be made. You're going to have sections, you're going to have neighborhoods that, you know, don't, say, provide the full level of living comfort - amenities that, you know, that we could provide.
Okay.
You know, there are a lot of social economic issues, particularly that are hitting the surface, as you well know, particularly now in this economic downturn that we're going through.
Right.
You know, crime rates have increased, social dissatisfaction has increased. You know, families have been affected principally because of the economic situation. So yeah, I mean, you know, improvements can always be made.
Okay.
I think that this administration, Mayor Nutter's, I think he's right on target as far as a lot of his programs are concerned to deal with neighborhoods and city rejuvenation, revitalization, and so forth. And I think that's perfectly consistent with what Jane Jacobs was hoping for.
And,
did that give you an answer to your question?
Yes, that's perfect.
Okay, did you like it?
Yes, that was good.
I want you to like the answers.
Yeah, next question is about the convention center. So with the expansion of the convention center, which is a total of 541,000 square feet, what negative effects will this have on that area of the city? And could there have been a better option that could attract more people to that area of the city?
Well, I know where the convention center is, but quite honestly, I haven't studied that area. I haven't looked at the area. I haven't really read anything about it. So if you wanted a response on the question, I'd have to give you a more generic response rather than a specific, you know, case example
right.
response vis-a-vis the Civic Center, Convention Center.
Right.
Anytime you have a major facility like that draws people, not really from the neighborhood. I mean, the purpose of that convention center is not to draw people from the neighborhood. It's to draw people from the outside. And how do they get there? They get there by car, or they get there by train or bus. So, you know, anytime you enlarge a facility like that, that's a major people attractor, you're going to have an impact.
Okay.
That's sort of a generic response to your specific question, which again, I'm not familiar with all the specifics of the convention center.
The impact would be for the better of the city, where more money would be coming into the city for more events at the place, rather than for people that just, you know, regularly live in the area that can use the facility for, or even use the land for other purposes.
Yeah, I think theoretically that's true. You know, again, you'd have to. I think the thing to do would be to look at other situations in other cities, you know, of a comparable size to Philadelphia, and try to examine try to search out. There are some case studies that would give you some specific documentation that, you know, would show, okay, when the Civic Center, whatever you want to call it, is expanded, you know, what has been the impact, positive and minus.
So you just talked about the high-rise buildings and the public homes. Public housing. The next question I have is about the Philadelphia Housing Authority. So in Philadelphia, we have the Philadelphia Housing Authority, and around Temple main campus, we've seen many small homes that are in street level, and it seems as though the city is moving away from the large-scale buildings for smaller homes. Do you think that it would be a good idea to include retail in and around these areas?
Jacob suggested
it would be good.
The simple answer is yes. But, you know, all answers to questions of that nature are not necessarily simple. I have to confess, I'm not familiar with, you know, the intricacies of the programs of the Philadelphia Housing Authority.
Okay.
But just from what I've seen in the neighborhoods contiguous to the campus, there are some improvements that seem to be rejuvenating or revitalizing, let's say, some of those neighborhoods. Now, a lot of the housing, of course, is not going to be conducive to having the mixed use that you suggest in your question, because they're single family, in most cases, what I've seen. Part of it is that they're single family, either semi-detached or row houses, you know, townhouses. So how those would play into having mixed uses, you couldn't do it in the same structure. You'd have to have things adjacent on other sites, or maybe across the street or whatever.